So hello fans, everyone from here in Korea. I'm Suresh Lakshmanan. I work for Borussia Dortmund as the Managing Director for Asia. And I'm very happy and glad to be here in Seoul, Korea. We obviously love to, most of my job will be to be doing a lot of activities here in Asia. And we see Korea obviously as one of our markets, especially for the Asian region. And to also take into account that we had former Korean players as well here in Dortmund. But at the same time, we want to build the relationship closely with our fans in Korea. We also have a relationship and partnership with one of our Korean brands, Hankook, as well. We want to start everything as we did in the past in Asia, but the most important thing is to build our relationship with our fans. We actually have increased our fan reach in Asia since 2014, and organically we've been growing the fan base in and around Asia. The Korean fans have been actively trying to reach to us. And we have had the chance this time to meet them. We've lost some momentum in the last few years, but now we gave us some time and opportunity to come to Korea and to be with them. I understand that the fan base have increased tremendously, or at least organically in the last few years, and this time we want to see what we could do with them. We had a chance to meet the fans, a couple of the fans, including the head of the fan club here in Korea, and we want to do and be close to them again as far as the Korean market is concerned. I mean, we had these three fantastic players. If I'm saying one of the three most significant Asian players, of course we had Shinji Kagawa with us from Japan, but with G Park and obviously with Lee, it tells you that there's a talent here in Asia, there's talent here in Korea. And at the same time, we still want to connect back with these players, especially when we are trying to build our brand further into the Korean market. We had a wonderful experience and opportunity to work with Lee in during the last Legend game in Hong Kong, and he still looked fit and still looked like a young player playing in Europe. But we want to make this an opportunity for us to connect back with these players to see what else we could do in Korea. Absolutely. I mean, this is also one of my objectives to come to Korea, to see if there's a platform for us to have a future Legends game here in Korea. As you mentioned, we had Lee in Hong Kong last month. And if Park is available, then to have Lee and Park in the same team to play in Korea for a Legends team, this will be spectacular. It will be an incredible occasion for BVB, and at the same time also for our fan clubs and our fans here in Korea. Sure. Again, coming to Korea, I mean, this is obviously our first visit for us in Korea, professionally for me. And we want to see what are the opportunities out there in the market here. One is obviously trying to do as much as we can with the fan club to do viewing parties, to bring players, legends down here to get close to the fans. We just had a meeting with Puma this morning, and this is something we could do with a meet and greet session to do Puma activities, raffles, signed shirts and merchandise. With Puma. On top of that, we are also trying to see how we could explore or at least try to reach youth players here in Korea. As you know, Dortmund is very well known for their youth philosophy, and we are extremely strong with our youth program. And we want to see how we could find a good cooperation here in Korea, especially with some clubs, some K-League clubs or some Korean academies here, and to find the right approach and build a youth program here. This will be nice, and to find an absolute good partnership with the brands especially with the clubs and the academies here, and give a platform, some of these youth players, a chance to understand how the BVB way is put together. I think you just mentioned the players, they are still with the team. I mean, prior to that we had Marcel Schmelzer, we had Nuri Sahin, and these players were all part of our youth academy, and we had prior to that of our legend as well, Lars Ricken, who scored the 97 winning goal against Juventus Turin. They were all part of our youth program and a youth academy, and this is something we are very strong at, and we want to explore and try to export, that's the right word I was looking for, export this methodology into Asia. And you can see, even till today, our players are relatively young. We have developed all the young players that came through the program. Christian Pulisic, for example, is a great example. Came to us at a very young age, and he's developed to be one of the best youth talent in the world right now. Of course, he's gone to Chelsea, but it shows you how strong our youth programs are. And this will always be our USP. This will always be our DNA. We will always try to develop youth players and want to make sure that they play at the highest level in the club and also in Europe. We are a club that develop. We are not a club that goes out to buy the next $100 million player, or we potentially develop the next $100 million player. So this is our methodology and philosophy that will never change. I mean, I think this is basically a question for the whole of Asia, and that's what we get in most of the requests or the interviews from the media. But I think what's important is how well the Asian players can adapt and adopt into a European setting. We are so fortunate to have the likes of Lee and with Park and Ju and Shinji with us. And you can see, if we are out there to look for an Asian player or for an Asian talent, they must contribute to the team. We're not just there to ensure that they buy that the fans buy the shirts of the player, for more from a marketing perspective. And I'm sure there are a lot of talents in Asia, and also there's a lot of talent in Korea, but we have to ensure that this is obviously not my expertise, but more from the technical team and the sportive department. But I'm confident at some stage that you would see more Korean players coming to play in the Bundesliga. As you can see, there are already Korean players, quite a number of Korean players playing in the Bundesliga. But at some stage, there would be or could be an opportunity for some of the young players to come through our academy, especially when they have the opportunity to do a trial, for example, in Dortmund. And if the coaches and the scouts are impressed with the performance, you'll never know that there could be a chance. But I'm keeping my fingers crossed, and I know, as far as Korea is concerned, they have such a wealth of talent. Look at Son, for example, where he is right now. And this could be a good opportunity for future young players here in Korea. I think our philosophy and our plans for Asia are very different. I mean, one is we set up the office in Singapore in 2014 because we feel that the team or the club has the opportunity to have a platform to internationalize their approach and reach. The Premier League clubs obviously had a head start than us, but our approach was different. We have partners already in Asia. For example, we have Evonik, which is our shirt sponsor, that have been in Singapore, and the Asia Pacific head office is there. Puma's Asia Pacific head office is also in Singapore. The DFL or the Bundesliga had their office in Singapore, so it made sense that we find an angle to be present in Singapore, and let alone in Asia, let alone in Singapore, so that it gives us a bridge, gives us a reach into the whole Asian market. We spent the last 3 years playing in Asia. We had in 2015 trained in Singapore, Malaysia, a match, as well as in Japan, and then the following 2 years we were in China. So we feel that even the black and yellow color has so well received in Asia, and to be one of the first Bundesliga clubs to also be in Asia. And we know there are a lot of fans out there, and they are unable to travel all the way to Dortmund, This is an opportunity for us to get close to them and try to bring the club to Asia. And that's the reason why we feel and see that the more we are present in Asia, the more we grow our fan base, the more we reach to the hearts of the people, the more the club is more popular and successful in Asia. So that's basically the philosophy of us. Look at the Korean market. As far as international brands are concerned, you have so many top Korean international brands. You can say Samsung, LG. We have a partnership with Hankook, for example. It shows how strong the brands are reached, not just in Asia, but internationally. And for us, we know that there is opportunities here, and not primarily from a commercial perspective, but also from a sportive perspective, and to see how we can connect the dots with the Korean market. Just being on the streets and also understanding that the football is so attractive here in Korea, and being the one of the first few Bundesliga clubs to be here, if not the first Bundesliga club to be here, set a good a statement or set a good mark for us to want to see what else we could do in Korea. Obviously, it helps if we could with the Korean league as well. As you can see, there are really top teams up in Korea, and some of the young players are also playing in the Korean league. And these are things that we feel are important for us here with the club in Dortmund. And the closer we get to the market, the closer we get to the fans, the closer we get to the products, to the brands, to the associations, to the federations, the more we can find an activity or explore an opportunity to work together. So that's basically what we want to do, and this is our first approach here in Korea. Everything is baby steps, small steps, little steps, but I think this is the right steps for us to get into the Korean market. I think you just said it. The goal is to want to be German champions. That's the main objective for us. I mean, we went out there and we did we managed to get the players as early as we can. And there's an intention that we want to close the gap with Bayern Munich. Last season was extremely close with only 2 points, and this season we want to win. We want to find a way to win, and this is our intention, that we are out there to sign the best one of at least the best players that's available. We're talking Hazard. Obviously, he's playing in Gladbach, and for him to play in Dortmund. And knowing and understanding the league itself that he's played for shows that there was an intention for us with Nico Schulz as well. So for me, I think this we've showed that the statement was there, that we want to prove that we are a team that can win the German league. But of course, we would love to be champions. Being in the Champions League is very, very important for us. But as you can see, this last season, we showed that we have the capability of being champions. And of course, in my personal opinion, I would want to see the club to be champions. But don't underestimate the likes of Bayern Munich and even RB Leipzig. They are also a strong team. And also the likes of Leverkusen, and Gladbach and even Schalke.
Yeah.
So, but these are... We cannot take the Bundesliga for granted that, you know, we will always end up being successful or strong in the top three or top four, but we have to continue to be consistent and ensure then try to find a way to at least get into the Champions League. And that's the must objective, or the main objective, but at the same time try to close the gap with Bayern and hopefully win the Champions League, the championship. I think the most important to answer your question, the most important element as far as how we take pride, it's our fans. This club is, you can see how much the fans love the club. You go to every part of Asia or any part of the world, you see black and yellow, and you can feel the love, echte Liebe. That's something which is true to our hearts. You can see the yellow wall, the 25,000 in the Sut Tribuna, standing, cheering. And this means a lot to us. And without the fans being there for us, I think it's difficult for us to play on a weekly basis. So to answer your question very simply, the fans are very important for us. And this is something which is extremely close to our hearts. It's the most amazing footballing experience ever, is to see exactly how the fans sing and cheer for us in the Signal Iduna Stadium.